हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ ट्विंकल पटेल फ्रॉम महात्मा गांधी इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्निकल एजुकेशन एंड रिसर्च सेंटर नवसारी। दिस वीडियो लेक्चर इज अबाउट फेस्टल साइफर। सो इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर वी विल स्टार्ट विथ सम ऑफ द बेसिक टर्म्स सच एज स्ट्रीम साइफर, ब्लॉक साइफर, कन्फ्यूजन, डिफ्यूजन। आफ्टर दैट वी विल डिस्कस द फेस्टल साइफर स्ट्रक्चर, एनक्रिप्शन एंड डिक्रिप्शन प्रोसेस इन फेस्टल साइफर, एंड देन वॉट आर द फैक्टर्स which is widely affect the Festal cipher structure. So first of all, we will start with stream cipher and block cipher. So stream cipher is a cipher that encrypts a digital data stream one bit or one byte at a time. Example are Vigenère cipher and Wernham cipher. Vigenère cipher and Wernham cipher, as we have studied in the earlier lectures. So stream cipher encrypts the data bit by bit or one byte at a time. Another type of cipher is known as a block cipher. So block cipher is a cipher which encrypts a block of plain text. Block of plain text is created as a whole and used to produce a ciphertext block of equal length. The example of block cipher are Festal cipher, DES, AES, DDS, etc. So in this video lecture, we are going to study the Festal cipher, DES, AES, and another cipher we will study in the upcoming lecture. So basically ciphers are divided and are two parts, stream cipher and block ciphers. Now we are going to study the block ciphers. In the earlier lectures we have studied the stream cipher. So next we will see confusion and diffusion techniques. So confusion is a technique which hides the relationship between the ciphertext and the key. One main aim of the confusion is to make it very hard to find the key even if attacker has a large number of plain text and the ciphertext produces with the same key. So this is achieved by the use of complex substitution algorithms. Next one is diffusion. Diffusion is a technique which uses the techniques to hide the relationship between the ciphertext and the plain text. So diffusion means that the output bit should be depend on the input bit in a very complex way. In a cipher with a good diffusion, if one bit of the plain text is changed, then the ciphertext should change completely. So this is achieved by complex algorithm. So diffusion and the good cipher contains the diffusion and confusion techniques widely. Next we will see Festal cipher structure. So Festal cipher is a block cipher structure. So we will see the generalized structure of the Festal cipher. So as you can see, this is the Festal cipher. So first of all, we have Festal cipher is a block cipher. So first of all, we have a block of the plain text which is divided. Now next we will divide this plain text into the two parts, that is left part and right part. After that, this plain text is go through the certain round. Here we have generally taken round number as a n. Generally the number of round are 16, 64, 128, etc. So Festal structure, first of all, divide the whole plain text into the two parts. After that, right part has no calculation and left part is given to the exclusive OR operator. And another input to the exclusive OR operator is the output of this function. So what is this function? This function take the two input. First is round key. Here every round require a key. So we have one common key. After that, from that key, we have to generate the key for every round using the key generation algorithm. So we have a key for every round. Here key and the right half of the plain text is applied to the function, and after that this output is given, this output and the left half of the plain text is given to the exclusive OR operator. Next, the output of this exclusive OR operation is considered as a right half of the next round, and the right half of the first round is considered as a left half of the next round. So in this way, For all the rounds, this process is continuously applied, and at the last, these left and right half are swept, and these swept part two parts are merged together, and ciphertext is generated. So this is the encryption process of Feistel cipher structure, and this is a generalized diagram of Feistel cipher structure or block cipher structure. So the first step is plaintext is splitted into the 32 bit halves, that is LI and RI. If our plaintext is of 64 bit, it may be of any length. Next step is RI, that is the right half is fed into the function F with the round key. Next is the output of that function, and the left half is XOR, and left and right half are swept. So this is a general procedure for the Feistel cipher structure. So here right half equal to now we will see mathematically. So right half equal to suppose consider R1 equal to, so right half equal to previous round left half exclusive OR with the output of the function, and the function is applied between the previous round right half and the key KI. Okay, and the left half of the next round is directly the right half of the previous round, that is RI minus 1. So this is a mathematical representation of right half and the left half in the Feistel cipher structure. Next, we will see the encryption and decryption process in the Feistel cipher structure. So this diagram shows the encryption and decryption process of the Feistel cipher structure. So left side procedure shows the encryption, and right side shows the decryption. So as we can know that the input to the encryption process is plain text. So we have already discussed the round by round process. So generally there may be 16 rounds in the Feistel cipher. So there are 16 rounds in our Feistel structure. So first of all, plain text is divided into two halves, L is 0. As we know that this is the encryption process, so we will indicate with left encryption 0 and right encryption 0. So left and right half are divided into the two parts, and after that right half is directly passed as a left half of the next round, and the right half is also applied to the function with the round key, and the output of that function is given to the exclusive OR operator with the left half, and this is considered as a right half of the next round. So in this way the procedure is continuous until the round 16, and at the round 16 these two blocks are swapped, and then these two blocks are merged together. So this is the encryption process in the Feistel cipher. Now decryption is the reverse process of encryption. So as we know that the input of the decryption process will be the ciphertext. So here the ciphertext is considered as an input to the decryption process, and the process will be remain same. The only difference between this encryption and decryption process in Feistel cipher is that the key will be reversely used. So for example, the round 1 will use the key of the round 16, and round 16 will use the key of the round 1. Next we will see the output of the first round, that is output of the first round of the decryption, that is the LD1 and RD1, which is equal to the 32 bit swap of input of the 16 round of encryption. So now we are going to prove that the output of the first round of the decryption, that is LD1 and RD1, which is equal to the input of the 32 bit swap of the 16 round of encryption, so that RD1 equal to RE15 and RD1 equal to the LE15. So we have to prove that this. So first of all, we have to prove that at LD1 equal to RE15 and RD1 equal to LA15. So consider the encryption side. So at encryption side, LE16 equal to RE15 and RE16 equal to exclusive OR of LA15, and the function will take K16 and RE15. So this is all about the round 16 of the encryption side. Next we will see the round 1 of the decryption side. So here LD1 equal to the RD0, and RD0 which is equal to the LA16, and LA16 which is equal to the RE15. From here. So LD1 equal to RE15, hence we have proof. Next we have to prove that RD1 is equal to LA15. So consider here RD1, which is exclusive OR of the LD0, and the function is applied between the RD0 and the K16. So here LD0 exclusive OR is, function is applied between RD0 and K16. But here we can see that LD0 is equal to RE16. So LD0 is replaced with RE16. And after that, here in function RD0. So here RD0 which is equal to the LE16, and LE16 which is equal to RE15. So here in function we are replacing RD0 with the RE15. After that, here we can see that RE16 which is equal to LE15 exclusive OR with function applied with between RE15 and K16. So here we are replacing RE16 with this formula. So LE15 exclusive OR with this, and then the term remaining is written here. So here we can see that the function applied between the RE15 and K16 exclusive OR with function applied between RE15 and K16. Both the function are same, and as we know that if both the terms in exclusive OR are same, then result will be 0. For example, x exclusive OR with x will give us a result 0. So the term LE15 exclusive OR with 0 will give, and anything which is exclusive OR with 0 will give us a dead term. So LE15 is the answer. So hence we have proved that RD1 will equal to the LA15. So this is the phase-tall encryption and decryption process, in which the decryption process is the same as the encryption process, only the keys are reversed for the each round. Next we will see some of the important phase-tall network factors. So first factor is block size. The common block size used in the phase-tall structure is 64 bit. However, the new algorithm, so algorithm can use 128-bit to 256-bit block size. And the key size of 64 is mostly used, but it is now considered as insufficient. So 128-bit become a common size. Typical number of rounds are 60. Next is round function f. So as we have earlier seen that every round has a round function f. So this phase consists of 16 rounds of the same function, which involve both permutation and substitution function. So these functions should be complex for the greater resistance to cryptanalysis. Next is sub-key generation algorithm. As we have seen that every round requires a key. So from our main key, we have to derive the different sub-keys. So for each of the 16 rounds, a different sub-key should be derived from the main key by the combination of the left circular shift and the permutation. So this subkey generation algorithm should be complex and difficult for resisting against the cryptanalysis attacks. So in this video lecture, we have discussed some of the important terms such as string cipher, block cipher, diffusion, confusion. After that, we have discussed the phase-tall cipher structure and encryption and decryption process of phase-tall cipher, and the important factors which consist of the phase-tall cipher. Thank you.